Hi there, this is Tex Beneke.
Now tune from a picture we made recently out in California. It's Mary and Tex and the Modernaires and Chattanooga Choo Choo.
Chattanooga Choo Choo was from the first Glenn Miller movie, Sun Valley Serenade, which I think we did in 1941. I did this along with Paula Kelly and the Modernaires. And when Glenn passed out the parts to the vocal group and myself, we all thought that that was probably one of the biggest dogs that had ever been written, and that it would never get off the ground. But sure enough, you know, it was one of our real big ones, and the first record to ever receive a gold award from RCA Victor for 1,250,000, I think, which was a lot of records in those days.
Step aside, partner, it's my day. Bend an ear and listen to my version
of a really solid Tennessee excursion.
Pardon me, boy, is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
Yes, yes, track 29.
Boy, you can give me a shine.
Can you afford to buy?
I've got my fare
and just a trifle to spare.
You leave the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four. Read a magazine and then you're in Baltimore.
Dinner in the diner, nothing could be finer
than to have your ham and eggs in Carolina.
When you hear the whistle blowing 8 to the bar, then you'll know that Tennessee is not very far.
Double all the coal in, gotta keep it rolling.
Chattanooga, there you are.
There's gonna be a certain party at the station.
Satin and lace.
I used to call Funny Face. She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roam.
Oh, Chattanooga, choo-choo.
Won't you choo-choo me home? Choo-choo me home.
Chattanooga choo-choo.
Pennsylvania 65,000 was written by Jerry Gray, who was one of Glenn's chief arrangers. And he did it just for laughs, and we played it a couple of weeks without a title. And every night people would say, "What's the name of that?" And we like it, but eventually, Glenn got on the bandstand one evening and said, "Guys, I think I have a title for that Jerry Gray tune that everybody likes and that we get a kick out of playing." He said, "I think that the telephone number of the Pennsylvania Hotel would fit this particular arrangement." Well, really, I don't have to say any more, because everyone knows how well that Pennsylvania 65,000 has gone over.
As our program gets underway, I see that there's every indication that Glenn and the boys are certainly glad to be back here at the Hotel Pennsylvania. Smiles on their faces, and even the first number says, Pennsylvania 6, 5,000.
Glenn Miller had a sound. It was created primarily by his saxophone section, which used the clarinet, one of the clarinets, as playing the melody, the high melody, and one of the tenors, first tenor, doubling that same melody an octave lower, with the other three saxes filling the harmonies, which gave it a very distinctive sound. Plus the boo-wah, the plunger style brass, boo-wah, boo-wah, Tuxedo Junction style, things like that. And that was Miller's invention.
Now for your dancing or listening pleasure, here's your old friend, Tuxedo Junction.
Every once in a while, there will be some lady come up to the stand and say, "Tex, I was the original girl in Kalamazoo." There was a lady came up to me one night during a break and said, "Tex, I want to thank you." And I said, "For what?" She said, "For helping my kids learn the alphabet." And she was raising her little kids to the beginning of A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I got a gal. It's always fun, though, to hear people's comments about different things that we play.
Light up and listen as the whole gang opens our serenade with the number one tune in the land. I got a gal in Kalamazoo.
Possibly our biggest request number. Anything that was real fast, he had some crazy idea about it being called a flag waver. So I remember one thing that sticks out in my mind was when Al Klink and I did tenor sax battle. It's such a tremendously fast tempo, it was awfully hard to play, but we got through it, and we still get calls for it.
Now back to the music with one of your favorites, one of we like to play for you, In the Mood.
Thank you.
certain time on today's Sunset Serenade, but remember to be on hand next Saturday, same time, for a new edition dedicated to our men in the service and you folks back home. Most important, though, is don't forget those postcards. Send them along. The boys will sure appreciate it. And until we're back with you again, we ask you to keep them flying. Bill?
Thank you very much, Glenn, for another very delightful Sunset Serenade. Be with us again next time, folks. In the meantime, this is the Blue Network of the National Broadcasting Company.
But Glenn was great for me. He was a very strict taskmaster. But we were all happy with the band, all the boys. We enjoyed playing with Glenn. And the longer we went on, the more we found out how much the public was digging it and how the records were going. And it was a beautiful sounding band. I'm just happy that I've had, I think, as good a life as any musician has ever had. It's been my pleasure.
There's nothing wrong, I'm sure, that going home won't cure. I'll find my peace of mind.